Hello friends, today we'll discuss how to enhance our home or small office network. You can buy the most powerful computer, phone, but it all doesn't matter if your home network is sucks. If you ever encountered connectivity issues or slow speeds, chances are you haven't replaced your router in a while, and it's quite possible that time to retire that black box with antennas that's been sitting in your closet for the past few years. Working as a system administrator for the last 10 years, I'm often faced with a setting up network and I can't help you with your choice. I don't have one size fits all solution, as each case is unique and you need to take your input data into account to make the best choice. But I can tell you what to look for when choosing a router in 2024. Also, since I don't have many subscribers yet, just write me a comment and I'll help you with the network setup. Let's get started. I could probably talk at length about various Wi-Fi standards, different technologies used in router, but that would be boring for everyone, so let me simplify things. At the moment, it's worth to pay attention only three standards that are currently used in Wi-Fi routers. You can find the routers on Amazon starting from $29 up to $2,500. How to choose the right one? So, first thing to consider is to focus on routers that support Wi-Fi 6, Wi-Fi 6E, and maybe Wi-Fi 7 if you really need it, but I wouldn't pay much attention to Wi-Fi 7 yet because it's fairly new standard and there's aren't many devices that support it yet. For instance, only latest generation of iPhones, it's iPhone 15 Pro, I guess, and MacBook Pros and MacBook Airs with a M3 Apple Silicon chip recently added support for the Wi-Fi 6E standard. There's no Wi-Fi 7 yet, so there's no point to paying extra for something you want to use. So we're considering routers that support Wi-Fi 6 and Wi-Fi 6E. And Wi-Fi 6E is a bit better because it uses new frequency band 6 GHz. To put it simply, it's like a newly built highway that nobody knows about it and you can freely use it. Since Wi-Fi 6E uses 6 GHz band, there aren't many devices that use this band, so you can feel much freer in this band, meaning you'll experience fewer interferences when connecting to it. Another important factor is the port speed. For instance, if you have an internet speed of over 1 gigabit, to fully utilize the bandwidth, you'll need a multi-gigabit WAN port of 2.5 gigabits or higher. It's very important where you put Wi-Fi device. It's crucial to try to position the access point in a way that minimizes line of sight obstruction between client and access point. Here's the real life scenario. Recently, I configured a similar router for my friend, and it turns out that when they moved the modem, they also moved the router. Consequently, a computer in the same room couldn't maintain a stable connection. When my friend called me, my first thing I asked was describe what was between the access point and the computer. It turns out there was a piano. As we know, piano have a large cast iron plate at their base, essentially as a huge piece of metal that acted as a shield, interfering with the connection. As soon as we raised the access point slightly higher, we immediately achieved a stable connection. The next thing to consider is the area of your space. Usually, when you choose a router, the specifications mention the coverage area. If you have, for example, one bedroom or two bedroom apartment, the most likely one device, one Wi-Fi router will be enough. If you're talking about larger homes, something bigger, two-story building and so on, here we need to consider each specific case because firstly we take into account the area of the space and secondly we consider the material from the which space is made. Here we should probably look if your house has Ethernet cables, then we can use connection and simply distribute access points through the house. And here we can already choose, meaning we have install a router controller and install access points, connecting them by wire. Wired connection is still the most reliable connection. And if we can use wired connection, I would be probably recommend to use it. Then, if we can afford to run wires, our next option is a mesh network. Mesh network can work wirelessly, meaning we'll have one connection to our router which acts as a controller, and we simply place the next device within the range of the primary controller and the position points in such a way that there's a slight overlap in the coverage area of these devices. And they start communicating with each other, thus providing coverage for our large home. This is the next thing we can use. I wouldn't recommend any specific device at the moment, I'll just mention and tell you what I'm currently using. For at least 5 years, I've been using Ubiquiti devices. There's access points, controllers that manage access points, switch, DVR systems, and I really like them. I've never had any problems with any of Ubiquiti devices for 5 years. UniFi is Ubiquiti's line of network equipment that includes a variety of devices suitable for both home and enterprise use. The UniFi ecosystem consists of wireless access points, routers, switch, security cameras, controllers, appliances, VoIP phones, and access control products. UniFi networks can be tailored to different settings from small apartments to large corporate environments with a thousand of devices. Users can start with a single device and expand their network over time, choosing the companies that suits their needs. The UniFi devices are managed through the UniFi network application, which provides a web interface for configuration and monitoring. Also, you can configure everything using just the application in your phone. Additionally, Ubiquiti offers a range of software applications like UniFi Protect for video recording, UniFi Talk for business telephony, and UniFi Access to Access Control System. Overall, UniFi provides a comprehensive solution for networking needs across various scales and environments. By the way, Ubiquiti founder Robert Pera worked at Apple before founding his company. And indeed, the approach to packaging, presentation and appearance of the device resembles that of Apple. Here's the router I bought recently, UniFi Express, and this is Apple Airport Express. A bit similar, isn't it? And building UniFi network should start with the fact that we need to choose a controller on which to run UniFi OS. By the way, you can run UniFi OS on the Docker container if you want. Or even you can run on the Windows, Linux and Mac OS. So, controller. We probably need a dedicated device for that. And let's talk about UniFi Express. Basically, it's entry point into the UniFi ecosystem. And there we should make a disclosure. This is not a sponsored review. Look, what I'm talking about, I have only 130 subscribers on my channel, so I bought the device with my own money, and this is going to be honest review as possible. Let's go. So, this little box is both a controller that runs the network app and the Wi-Fi 6 access point that can also work in mesh mode. I'd like to see Wi-Fi 6E, but it is what it is. I can always buy another Wi-Fi 6E access point and expand coverage if I want to. That's the advantage of the UniFi system. It can grow with you and you can replace the components you need without changing the whole system. Here we can see the specifications. The package including the device itself, a power adapter, high quality Ethernet cable and paper with a QR code that directs you to download the application. For the initial setup, there are two scenarios. In the first scenario, your provider allows you to use your own router to connect to the network, to ISP network. In this case, we simply connect the internet provider cable to a WAN port. If we have a switch, we connect to LAN port. Let's pause for a moment to discuss the switch. I highly recommend connecting devices that don't move via cable, such as TV, streaming device, gaming consoles, and so on. That's why we can reduce the load on the Wi-Fi network and provide stable connections for the most demanding device in our network. The second scenario is if your ISP does not allow you to use your own device to connect directly to its network, for example, AT&T. in my case. In this case, we have to enable pass-through mode on the device provided by the provider, by the ISP. So, in the case of pass-through, we turn off Wi-Fi on that device and connect the LAN port to the WAN port of our UniFi Express. Everything I'm saying will work on other routers too. After connection, we install the UniFi application and launch it. For the initial setup, Bluetooth is used to make sure it's enabled on your phone. Once the device detected, we proceed with the setup. It's also straightforward there. We specify the name of our Wi-Fi network. If you don't want to reconnect every device, just name your network the same as it was before. Now together we will go through the initial setup. Here's the setup is complete and it took about 2.5 minutes. And our device is ready. This is the main page of our device where we can see our device. We can see the number of network device connected to the device, a number of clients, our IP address and activity and so on. So we can also change the convenient settings and for us through the app on the smartphone from here. But I find it more convenient to use the web interface. And let's go to the web interface. When we open the web interface, we get something like the pretty dashboard where we can see pretty much everything we need to know about our network. Here we can see traffic identification, here see active clients, active access points, and what technologies are used, as well as additional information. And the next section is topology, and this is my favorite. I really like topology because here you can see quite clearly and understandably what devices are currently connected to where. If you have more complex network and you have not just one device, but say you have deployed several access points, switch and so on, all these will be displayed correctly. Here you can see the topology with types, no needs to build anything manually. We can also go directly to each device through the this topology, click on the device and perform certain action with it. That is with it. For example, we can open a TV and block it access to internet because it doesn't need to go to internet and send any data about what we're watching on this TV. And we can easily do that. The next step is UniFi devices. These are devices that are present in our network. As we can see, I only have one device here. We can fully view all information about the ports, completely change all settings of the device if we need. All is done here. We can also scan our surrounding networks in order to select optimal channel. And I want to dwell on this little more because when you first install a router or access point, you may not get the speed you expected. And this because by default or randomly the access point chooses some channel when you first connect, and this may not be the best channel. There may be multiple access points operating on this channel. I advise you to scan the channels, and UniFi devices can do this and they can do it regularly. You can set channel scanning to happen every night, for example, and the best channel is be selected to ensure the best coverage. So we select a channel, everything was scanned, and then we move to the next step. And this is our next step, and that is just a table representation of what we already seen in the topology tab. There's a roughly speaking have all the devices that we can interact with in some way, change settings and so on, view information, and so all the information connected to our network with additional information is here. Next one is the ports. For ports, we can change the port settings for device like say UniFi switch or UniFi Dream Machine or others. That is, we can assign specific ports to specific VLAN, assign different VLANs and send speed and so on. Next step is radios, and here we can see our access points. In the case we have one access point, but it works as a two access points, 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz. That just turns out it's a dual band. Here we see additional information about that, and what cool is that we have an environment tab where we can clearly see what networks around us, what the strength of this network is, what channel they operate on. That's very useful to be able to troubleshoot our wireless net. Next, we have the gateway tab where we can see what traffic is being filtered, what traffic we have, and what if we have ads filter, if we have enabled and filter and so on. The next tab for us is logs. If you need to find information about what was happening with your devices, you can find that information here. And I think the most interesting part will be the settings, because in the settings, you can create create additional network. We can create a guest network, for example. This one thinks. Secondly, you can create separate network for a device like IoT device. That is, this device will work in a completely separate network and not have access to your other device. This is very useful if you want to increase security of your network. The next step is networks, where you can create VLANs, create the same thing, but for wired network. And the next interesting tab is VPN. This is probably what's worth buying UniFi for. Here we have four tabs. We can use this device as a VPN server. This is a VPN server that doesn't require any configuration. You just check this checkbox and install the WiFi Man app on your phone. And if you logged in into your online account on your device, then you can simply quickly connect to your home network from anywhere. And I strongly recommend doing this when you're using open access points somewhere in coffee shops or cafes. And also here, there are many different variations of VPN protocols. There's WireGuard, OpenVPN, IPsec, L2TP. We can use site-to-site. We can combine data using this device remote sites with each other, organizing one single network, and so on. Next is security tab. And in security, we can enable ad blocking, we can enable device identification and traffic identification. We need this so that we can see in our dashboard what devices are connected and what direction on our device are using resources. And we can also here, I don't know, restrict certain countries if we need. In traffic rules, we can add or restrict specific app for specific devices on our network. And on top of that, we can also add schedule for this blocking. For example, we can block certain apps for your kids, which I think is quite useful. Next, we have port forwarding and firewall rules. I very strongly recommend that you don't use port forwarding for your network. And if you need to get access to some resources inside your network from outside, please use VPN. This is the much more secure way to do what you need. Next, we have firewall rules. That is, we can flexibly configure network in the way we need. And this is a huge number of settings that we can use. Next, we have routing. Then we have profiles. So it's going to be useful to manage big, complex networks. Well, in the system settings, you can back up your configuration. We can save it locally, or we can store it on Ubiquiti servers, which is pretty cool because backup, if it's stored only in one place, it's not truly backup. And I guess that's about it in the settings. So the main advantages, I think, and why I choose the UniFi devices. First, the price. That's for very low price, we get a high-end device with a polished interface, with a functional operation system, which allow us to configure our network. So that is secure, fail-tolerant, reliable, and fail-safe. That's all we need. Upon looking at the market, it seems that there are no competitors to UniFi devices at this price point. I hope the price remains affordable moving forward. Thanks everyone for watching. If you have any question about setting up your network or you want to hear any recommendation or advice, let me know in comments. And one more important factor why I choose UniFi. UniFi works with a home assistant. That is, if you use automation in your home network, home assistant works perfectly with UniFi devices. So you can create different automations using UniFi devices like smart sensors, access points, and all this stuff. So we'll talk about it a little bit later in my next videos. Thanks everyone for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video. See you later. Bye guys.